city, the partner states undertook to adopt policies and mechanisms to promote the efficient exploitation, development, joint research and utilization of various energy resources available within the region, and to promote the utilization of new and renewable energy sources. And whereas the cooperation of the partner states in energy is supported by the commitment of the partner states to supply affordable energy to the people of the community, while recognizing the protection of the environment as provided for by Chapter 19 of the treaty, recalling the aspiration of the community as expressed in the EAC Vision 2050 to ensure sustainable, adequate, affordable, competitive, secure, and reliable supply of energy to meet regional needs at the least cost, while protecting and conserving the environment in line with the sustainable development goals. Mindful that the sixth EAC development strategy for financial years 2021-2022 to 2025-2026 includes access to clean energy as one of the strategic development objectives of the community for the next 5 years, noting with pride that the community is endowed with a vast amount of renewable energy resources, including significant wind and solar energy, organic waste for sisal production, sawdust from lumber mills, and byproducts from tea and coffee, which can be harnessed for generation of renewable energy throughout the community. Grateful to the Council of Ministers for establishing the East African Center of Excellence for Renewable Energy and Energy Efficiency, EACREEE, with the overriding objective of contributing towards increased access to modern, affordable, and reliable energy services, energy security, and mitigation of negative externalities of the energy system, local pollution and emissions by creating an enabling environment for renewable energy and energy efficiency, markets, and investments. Aware that EAC Secretariat and the East African Center of Excellence for Renewable Energy and Energy Efficiency are committed to developing and implementing a coherent regional renewable energy and energy efficiency policy framework for the community and facilitate its implementation at national levels by developing and executing regional programs and projects with the other partners and mobilizing funding, creating synergies with ongoing community programs, and operate as a key entry point for the implementation of international funding to mitigate climate change in their energy sector. Concerned that biomass, including charcoal, wood, and crop residues, biofuel or waste remains the dominant cooking and heating fuel in the community, with alarming figures of over 75% of renewable energy as a percentage of final energy consumption in 5 of the partner states, with the exception of South Sudan, which has a low percentage of 30%. Further concerned that the heavy reliance on these traditional solid fuels, such as wood and charcoal, especially for household cooking and heating, particularly affects women and girls, especially those who live in rural areas where they devote substantial portions of their working time and energy to maintenance of tasks of family, such as collecting firewood and cooking, cleaning of utensils, blackened by soot that are considered the domestic tasks and which reduce the capacity of women and girls to be productive in other areas. Conscious that Article 121 of the treaty recognizes the significant contribution of women in socioeconomic development, and that it is impossible to implement effective programs for the economic and social development of the community without the full participation of women. Recognizing that the sustainable development of the community requires concerted efforts and creative solutions by the public and the private sector, and the essential role of the private sector as a provider of capital and a driver of innovation. Recurring the resolution of the 138th Assembly of the Interparliamentary Union of March 2018 relating to renewable energy, among others, to engage the private sector in implementing the sustainable development goals, especially on renewable energy. Convinced that it's necessary and urgent for the community to harness the vast potential and resources on renewable energy existing abundantly within the community, and to reduce the heavy reliance on traditional solid fuels such as wood and charcoal, especially for household cooking and heating, and its adverse and disproportionate effects on women and girls. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Assembly as follows, that in accordance with Article 49, sub Article 2G of the Treaty, the Assembly urges the Council of Ministers and the partner states to A, promote the utilization of the abundant renewable energy resources of the community, B, enhance access to affordable and efficient renewable energy by women and girls, especially those living in rural areas, to support households and rural electrification. C, engage and facilitate the private sector through public-private partnerships in the exploitation and supply of modern sustainable energy solutions for the community. D, enhance the economic empowerment of women by engaging them in existing renewable energy income generating projects. E, direct the Secretary General to explore and enhance engagement with the development partners to increase and source support programs that boost household energy access, eliminate the time and health burdens of cooking by introducing improved and modern sustainable technologies. Mr. Speaker, I beg to move.
Thank you, Honorable Francois. If you can switch off your microphone.